What's up everyone, welcome to another video. Of course I tried something new. That was my new unboxing style. I wanted to see if I can even try it without any audio, just unbox it and see how you guys like it. If you do like it, let me know in the comment section if you did like some unboxing style of this. But anyway, the video is about this guy right here. It's the microphone called Shure MV7. It's a podcasting mic they have branded it as a podcasting mic. This brand is super popular. A lot of filmmakers, a lot of professional people uses this mic. So that's why I got this brand. They uses a different model, but they just released this model, I think, a couple months back, and I wanted to try it. This costed me about $250 with taxes and everything, probably $270. I still have to buy some accessories because right now this is on very cheap, $10, $20 a stand. So I need to buy a nice boom stand so that I can, you know, move it around and things like that, or just have a normal stand right here. But this one, for now, I think for this video, the work will be done. There are a lot of videos already out there talking about the feature and how awesome this mic is. So I don't want to talk about all the technical details, or all I can say is it's one of the best brands out there for podcasting mic, or for mic in general. This video is not sponsored by this. This is one of the addition to my YouTube care. I don't really know if it was even worth it, or if it is worth it, or if it was even needed. I think it is worth it, but the question is, do I really need it? Answer is no, probably not. But I just, you know, the more quality I improve, the more motivation I get to make better content in quality. So that was one of the reason, and I'm gonna try it and see. I still have 30 days return policy, so if I don't like it, I can always return it. I don't think I'm gonna return it, but we'll see. Or I might actually even buy it one more, so when we have two guests, I can use this professional quality podcasting mic. Before I start talking anything more, I want to switch the quality to this mic. So all of right now what you heard so far was from my mic on the camera. I'm gonna switch to this mic. 1, 2, 3. All right. Is there any difference in the quality? I think there's gonna be difference. I know for sure because I've seen so many videos. I was testing right before filming this video. I know that there's gonna be a little bit of quality difference. I just don't know how much and if it was all worth it. We'll see. So now when I start doing a lot of standalone, you know, talking to the camera type video, I'm going to be using this mic so that the quality is better. In my filmmaking class and lesson, they say that the audio is 50% of the viewing experience. So sometimes if your camera quality is not good, or if it is not great, that's okay. Audience will let it go. But if the audio is horrible, people will not be able to let it go. So audio is equally important as visuals. If audio is bad, then people will not even watch it. That's the statistics and fact. And so that's why I hope that this improves the quality of the video. I don't know how much noise reduction it has. Right now I'm using all automatic settings. There's a software they have. I'm directly recording it to my computer right now, and I'm using a software, and everything, the way I've set it up is all manual. All automatic, because there are some manual settings and I didn't have enough time to play around. So I'm gonna use it automatic for now. So one of the coolest thing is that there's a touch feature right here. And that is super cool, because it's you don't even have to touch it. It's you hover over it and it changes the gain, it changes the modes and things like that. It can mute, unmute it, it can lock, unlock it. So that's one of the cool feature of this mic. Another cool feature of this mic is that it can now connect directly through USB or USB-C. Which is what I'm using right now to connect to my computer. No problem, it's connecting, super awesome. I'm right now using QuickTime Player on my Mac. For people who have Apple MacBook, that's what I'm using right now. But if you know any software for MacBook which I can be using to record my audio, I myself have to get used to this setup, so close to my mouth, but But it's you know, it gives you that feeling of professional. Like now when I see those professional podcasters like Jay Sherry and Tom Bilyeu, they use such mics and Beer Biceps and Viral Alavalia, Alabadia. And Villa, I don't know, Beer Biceps guy. So he doesn't use this mic, he uses the same brand. But anyway, hopefully this also increases our quality. Hopefully it increases your viewing experience. That is it for this video. I will see you guys in the next one. Until then, keep smiling and keep hustling. Gotta hustle every single day. There's also a dark mode, which I don't know how it's gonna sound. So I switched to dark mode. I don't know. Is there a difference in the audio? I'm gonna like try to do this. There's also a bright mode. Is a bright mode better than dark mode or natural mode? And this one was the automatic. So now this is gonna be the most natural voice of mine. But bright mode, this is a bright mode. And then this is a dark mode. I don't know. Let me know in the comment sections. Also, let me know what you guys think about the series of unboxing and tech stuff.